Bang! What is up, all National Wrestling Shooters members and viewers? This is Scott Casey Gale, the owner of the National Wrestling Shooters. And today, I'm going to give you my WWE War reveal. It was from the Pepsi, they were at the Pepsi Center in Denver, Colorado. And the commentators for the show were Vic Joseph, Dio Madden, and Jerry the King Lawler. And this is Draft 2. The end of the 2019 draft. And I gotta say, it was a garbage war. This war absolutely sucked. And the 2019 draft was a waste of time. Okay, let's begin with the reveal, shall we? Here we go. Okay. Alright, so the show starts with Raw Women's Champion Becky Lynch defeated Charlotte Flair. Before the match, Becky Lynch cut a promo, and Charlotte came out, and they got into a bar, and they got into a major bar, and it ended up being a match where Raw Women's Champion Becky Lynch defeated Charlotte Flair. Charlotte hit a spear on Lynch, but Lynch kicked out at two. Charlotte was upset, allowing Lynch to roll up for free. This gave Raw the first pick in the night's draft. So Seth Rollins announced that he's going fiend hunting. Oh, this was cringe. I'm sorry, but Seth Rollins' promos suck. He needs to go back to being a heel or get a mouthpiece someone that can actually talk. But Seth Rollins sucks anyway as the Universal Champion. Fiend hunting, really, Seth? Really? So then Stephanie McMahon LeBesque announced the first round of draft picks. Universal Champion with Seth Rollins was Raw's first pick. Predictable. And WWE Champion Brock Lesnar was SmackDown's choice. Predictable. Raw then chose Charlotte Flair and Andre Jason Almas and Zelina Vega. And SmackDown chose The New Day. Predictable. Seth Rollins, I knew Seth Rollins, the Universal Champion, wasn't going anywhere. And we all knew that Brock Lesnar was going to be dropped to SmackDown because Fox wanted it. Really, WWE, quit insulting our intelligence. We're not stupid. Anyway, meh draft picks. They could have done so much better. And then Andre defeated Ali after interference with Zelina Vega. Andre won with a hammerlock DDT. This was a pretty decent match. I didn't mind it. And then in round two of the draft, Raw drafted Women's Tag Team Champions the Kabuki Warriors, and SmackDown took Daniel Bryan. So Daniel Bryan remained on SmackDown. He didn't get drafted to Raw. Raw then chose Rusev, while SmackDown picked SmackDown Women's Champion Bayley. Typical, of course. Raw closed out the second one by choosing Aleister Black, which I thought was pretty cool. But anyway, the rest, it was a waste of time. Nobody went anywhere. They remained on the same show. What the hell, WWE? And then the third match was War Tag Team Champions, the Viking Raiders. I call them the War Raiders. Defeated Robert Roode and Dolph Ziggler. Eric pinned Dolph Ziggler after the Viking Experience to win the match and the War Tag Team Champions. Pretty good match. I thought this is a really, really good tag team match. And congratulations to the Viking Raiders on becoming the new Raw Tag Team Champions. And we found out why the Viking Raiders became the tag team champions. It was a good match. And then in round three, Raw chose Cedric Alexander, Humberto Carrillo, which I thought was pretty cool, and Eric Rowan. And SmackDown chose Shinsuke Nakamura and Ali, so they remained on SmackDown. Mustafa Ali and Shinsuke Nakamura remained on SmackDown. What a joke. What a joke of a draft this is. And then Aleister Black defeated Eric Young by submission for Dragon Sleeper. Squash match. Typical squash match. Aleister Black deserves way better than this. And then in round four draft picks, Raw selected Buddy Murphy. Okay. Jinder Mahal. Really? really WWE? Do you think we're stupid? Jinder Mahal? I don't care about Jinder Mahal. What the hell? That is another insult to our intelligence. And then R-Truth. And SmackDown took Dolph Ziggler, Robert Roode, and Carmella. So that's why Dolph Ziggler and Robert Roode lost the Raw Tag Team Champions. Wow. This draft just keeps getting worse and worse. And again, they show the USA and Fox Network executives. We acting terrible, acting very, very cringeworthy, very cringeworthy. And of course they showed NFL people from the NFL, and they showed two SNL Saturday Night Live characters. Really more? And seriously, did we need to have all these NFL guys and NHL news people on there? Really, WWE? I mean, it's nice to have them on there, but really? You think this is actually going to bring... I mean, it was cringeworthy. You think this is actually giving fans what they want? You think people are actually going to tune into this? No, they're going to tune away. So then the OC beat the Street Profits backstage in the clingy pose area. Okay. So they're planting the seeds for the OC versus the Street Profits. Okay, I'm cool with that. And then match number 5, Ricochet defeated Shelton Benjamin. Ricochet countered a top rope arm drag by landing on his feet and then hit the Ricochet to win the match. Decent match, pretty decent match, but nothing really special. And then this was garbage. This was terrible. Tyson Fury and Braun Strowman had a contract signing for their upcoming match at Crown Jewel in Saudi Arabia, like I really care. And then Fury said he would knock Strowman out, causing Braun to break the table. Fury then awkwardly broke a pen to end the segment. Cringeworthy. Absolutely cringeworthy. You can tell this was scripted. WWE won't let Tyson Fury be himself. If they let Tyson Fury go unscripted, then you'd be in for a surprise. But all in all, this was cringeworthy. Totally gubs. I do not care. I don't really care about Braun Strowman versus Tyson Fury at Crown Jewel. Who they're only doing this for blood money. That's all it's about. Blood money. Blood money in Saudi Arabia. And then Wild 5 picks Ward chose Samoa Joe, Akira Tozawa, and Shelton Benjamin. SmackDown chose The Miz and King Corbin. I'm not surprised. And then Buddy Murphy defeated Cedric Alexander with Murphy's Law. This is kind of a squash match, but it was an all decent match. And then for the final draft pick, Ward gets Rey Mysterio, Titus O'Neil, and Liv Morgan, and SmackDown gets Chad Gable, which is actually his name, and Elias. This 2019 draft sucked. It was a horrible draft. The 2002 draft with Ric Flair and Vince McMahon, which was the first ever draft. The second draft, the 2004 draft with my personal favorite general managers of all time, Eric Bischoff and Paul Heyman. And the 2016 Dean Wants SmackDown draft were 10 times better than this insult to our intelligence. This cringeworthy, horrible draft. The 2002, 2004, 2016 draft blows the 2019 draft right out of the water. Because in 2002 and 2004, they were smart. WWE was smart. That's when Vince McMahon had brain cells. Even in 2016, I think they were still kind of smart. But this, what the hell? This is wrestling, not the National Football League. Nice try, WWE. Nice try. But this 2019 draft, like I said, was garbage with a capital G. This was garbage and trash to a T. And then the main event match was a women's tag team champion, the Kabuki Warriors, defeated Lacey Evans and Natalya. Asuka pinned Evans with a roll-up. I did not care. I'm happy the Kubicki War is with really, of all people, Lacey Evans. Lacey Evans is on SmackDown. What? Oh, God. This is definitely a piss break match. I would say this is more of a piss break match because it didn't really do anything for any of them. And then the show ended with Seth Rollins invading the Firefly Funhouse and literally burning it down. Rollins and The Fiend are having a Faust Count Anywhere match at Crown Jewel. Okay, I enjoyed the Firefly Funhouse segments, I always do, but I hope this is not the last Firefly Funhouse segment. And Seth Rollins got booed and he deserved it. WWE still hasn't learned from that ridiculous Hell in a Cell referee stoppage match. They still haven't learned that Seth Rollins beating the hell out of The Fiend. Seth Rollins is not the guy. He is the horrible universe, and he is the horrible WWE Universal Champion. Finn Balor, the first Universal Champion, was better than Seth Rollins. Hell, even Kevin Owens was a better Universal Champion than Seth Rollins. Hell, even Bill Goldberg was a better Universal Champion than Seth Rollins. And yes, I'm going to say it. Even Brock Lesnar was a better Universal Champion than Seth Rollins. Now they're going to have a match. I hope Bray Wyatt wins the Universal Champion and beats Seth Rollins. In my opinion, Bray Wyatt is on SmackDown, I really hope he wins. In my opinion, Bray Wyatt should be a free agent. He should go wherever he chooses. Because Bray Wyatt, The Fiend, is the best character WWE has right now. And they're kind of ruining him now by having Seth Rollins attack him. They're trying to bury him. WWE apparently hasn't learned. They haven't learned that fans, like I said, Vince McMahon keeps getting stupider and stupider. WWE keeps getting stupider and stupider. They just love to insult our intelligence and disrespect us and think that Seth Rollins is the guy, but he's not. But anyway, I would rate this war another 1 out of 4. Horrible war, a D plus, and 1 star. I did not care about this war. I will be back here later to do an NWA Power Episode 2, which I know is definitely gonna be way better than this crappy war. And then I'm gonna reveal NXT and AEW Dynamite, which I know is gonna definitely be better than this war. And I'll be back here on Friday to reveal Friday Night SmackDown. But anyway, you stay classy, live long and prosper, and peace out. And I must have bid you adieu, good night, and goodbye, and bang! In the words of Captain Shark, bang bang. Good night, everybody.